see this beautiful lady smoking around with me. And then she asked me, do you feel all right? And I say, yes, I feel wonderful tonight. That you just don't realize how much I love you. It's time to go home now. Need a bed, and then I tell her as I turn out the light, I say, my darling, you are wonderful tonight. Oh, my darling, you are wonderful. She's a long, long hair. And then she asked me, do I look alright? And I say, yes, you look wonderful tonight. Go to a party and everyone turns to see this beautiful lady walking around with me. And then she asks me,
in the sight of God, to witness and bless the joining together of Jeremiah and Amanda in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us male and female for each other. With his presence and power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and his sacrificial love gave us the example of the love of husband and wife. Amanda and Jeremiah come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant. Now to those who are to be married, I ask you now in the presence of God and these people to declare your intention to enter into union with each other through the grace and peace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself as acknowledged in your baptism. Amanda, will you have Jeremiah to be your husband? To live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live. If you will, would you say, I will? Jeremiah, will you have Amanda to be your wife? To live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live. If you will, would you say,
I will.
A little emphasis there never hurt. And to the people gathered here this day, will all of you, by God's grace, do everything in your power to uphold and care for these two persons in their marriage? If you will, would you say, we will?
We will.
And now a prayer from a Celtic monk for Jeremiah and Amanda. As spring unfolds, the dream of the earth may bring each other's hearts to birth. As the ocean finds calm in view of land, may you love the gaze of each other's mind. As the wind arises free and wild, may nothing negative control your lives. As kindly as moonlight might search the dark, so gentle may you be when light grows scarce. As surprised as the silence that music opens, may your words for each other be touched with reverence. As warmly as the air draws in the light, may you welcome each other's every gift. As elegant as dream absorbing the night, may sleep like the clear of anger and hurt. As twilight harvests all the day's color, may love bring you hope. The Lord be with all of you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. God of all peoples, you are the true light, illuminating everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the life. You love us even when we are disobedient. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit. We rejoice in your life in the midst of our life. We praise you for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now a proclamation of the word from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 through 17. Therefore, as God's choice, holy in love, put on compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience. Be tolerant with each other, and if someone has a complaint against anyone, forgive each other. As the Lord forgave you, so also forgive each other. And over all these things, put on love, which is the perfect bond of unity. The peace of Christ must control your hearts, a peace into which you are called in one body, and be thankful people. The word of Christ must live in you richly. Be prepared to warn each other with all wisdom by singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Sing to God with gratitude in your hearts. Whatever you do, whether in speech or action, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And give thanks to God and Father through him. This is the word of God for the people of God. I have the amazing opportunity of meeting both Jeremiah and Amanda at different times in life. I met Jeremiah first at Baker University. I remember he joined the track and field team at Baker. As a javelin thrower, he was much better than I ever was. He was a heptathlete. I ended up picking up decathlon after him. But I remember that bond was made. We were fraternal brothers as well. After undergraduate study, Jeremiah and I found each other once again and lived with each other for close to 4 years. We were the closest of friends and still are. And in that time that we had joined each other in friendship and cohabitation, I started a new appointment at a church in Olathe called Aldersgate United Methodist Church. And when I started that appointment, I never knew what that would entail. But I convinced Jeremiah to come to church one Sunday, and that Sunday bring him into church and introduce him to his. It is an honor and a joy to be with you. We have much to celebrate this day. And let us not forget that we don't stop celebrating today. We continue to lift them up in prayer. We continue to care for them. Not just today, but for all the days to come. You have all of our support. One of the wonderful things that this couple has decided that they wanted to do was to write each other letters for their first year anniversary that they can exchange to each other for their fifth year anniversary. They have chosen to write those letters to each other and have a private exchanging of those letters over their honeymoon. And so that's something that will carry with them beyond this day to help them remember the exact emotions, the feelings you had for each other later on in life. They've also selected to write each other vows. And so at this point in time, I would invite Jeremiah to read his vows to Amanda.
Amanda, the love I have for you extends beyond the capabilities of one stop office. The respect I have for you is your character, your intellect, and your compassion. You inspire me with your unwavering dedication. Stand by me in my doubt and failure. I promise to keep you in my heart. I promise to hold and kiss you every day I can. I promise to build you up and share my life with you. I give you my heart, for you are the present.
Now comes to a time in the ceremony where we get to exchange the rings for the bride and the groom. These rings are symbols. They are outward and visible signs of an inward and outward spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of Jeremiah and Amanda in holy marriage. Please exchange these rings with one another. You have declared your consent and vows before God and this congregation. May God confirm your covenant and fill you both with grace. I would invite you to face the congregation present. And to the people, now that Jeremiah and Amanda have given themselves to each other by solemn vows with the joining of hands and giving and receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. I now introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jeremiah May.
Y'all hear me okay?
Okay.
Welcome everyone. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. First, I'd like to thank my wife Pam for all of her hard work over the past 11 months. I'd also like to thank Jeremiah's parents, Troy and Billy, for being so easy to work with during this journey, Troy and Billy. And we couldn't ask for better in-laws for my daughter. Also, I'd like to thank Troy in advance for all the farm ponds and strip pits where he's gonna be taking me fishing. So thank you, Troy.
Yeah.
As I look at Amanda, I can't help but look back at all the years I was lucky enough to watch her grow and become the beautiful woman. Both inside and out that she is today. She captured my heart on the day she was born, and throughout the years I've been in awe by her total compassion, loyalty, and kindness for all things in life. She's my little girl, my princess, and no matter what her age, she would always be those things to me. Since they were very young, I always told Amanda and her sister Lindsay, if you can't do something, you're not trying hard enough. There are other reasons not to be able to do things, but can't isn't one of them. And Amanda has learned that lesson well, and I am so very proud of her for that. However, those words have come back to bite me. Every once in a while, I will use the word can't, and Amanda will promptly say, Dad, what? You're not trying hard enough. Jeremiah, welcome to our family. When I first saw you and Amanda together, I knew it was meant to be. When y'all first started dating, Pam and I would ask Amanda how it was going, and Amanda immediately replied, he's very good to me, and he always treats me with respect. And that's all a dad needs to hear. Landon, I'm especially excited to welcome Landon to our family. Landon, you have already brought so much joy and happiness to him and I. I look forward to finishing the bat house we have started, going to sporting KC games like we have, and you teaching me to floss later tonight. You are smart and kind, and you can accomplish anything in life that you want to. Today, as I watch Amanda marry this wonderful man, I am filled with pride. I am confident that Amanda and Jeremiah are beginning an amazing journey filled with the love and happiness that only the bond of marriage can provide. May the two of you always treat each other with love, compassion, respect, and kindness. I ask you all now to join me in congratulating the bride and groom and wishing them all the best for a long and happy life together.
Evidently, this could be impressive.
Yeah.
This can end in two ways. One, kind of okay, or train wreck. And my family this year is kind of just like, they're hoping not for train wreck, but We're on the right path. I don't know, you know, this whole thing and your journey a year ago and Jeremiah and Amanda, wow. You know? I mean, it's like almost speechless because, you know, you can't put everything into words. It's the feelings that we have. We got a little louder here so we can hear that. And anyway, so it's like, you know, something.
Come back that way.
Stay right there.
Am I too animated?
No.
Oh, it's cutting now. Very good. All I'm saying is this. It's like, these guys are have been awesome. And, you know, just to see them over the last few years and this, you know, evolving into where we're at today. Because as a parent, not that I'm old or anything like that, but you think back to the first times that your children are born and you're looking at them, and it's like, what are they going to look like? What color is their hair going to be? What color is their eyes before they're born? And then after they're born, it's like, what are they going to sound like, you know? And, you know, what kind of great conversations, what great adventures are we going to have to do, you know? And you're trying to imagine this, and you're trying to imagine the end. It's like, well, what does that look like, you know, 30 years later, 25 years, whenever that day is? And then you're here, and you can't imagine that, but then it's better than what you thought you could have imagined. So all I'm saying is, you know, these guys are loved. There is so much of you guys out here that have spent so much a part in their time, has been there from the very beginning, and I'm just grateful to be part of it. You know, there's a lot of work that went into this. So everybody's made, you know, out here for, not for me, but for a Jeremiah and for an Amanda. Yeah. And I'm blessed that they're together now. And Amanda, thank you. Welcome to this family. Some of them, yeah, you know, back and forth. But anyway, Amanda and Jeremiah.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Alright guys, so over the years I've learned from all my friends' relationships and marriage, there's five simple words to a good marriage and relationship. I apologize, and you are right. Good evening, family and friends. My name is Cameron. I am Jeremiah's best man. I want to start by saying to both of you, congratulations. Been looking forward to this moment for quite a long time now. But I've seen you and Amanda blossom from the beginning into such a beautiful relationship. You truly were made for each other. Amanda, you are one of the most kind-hearted individuals I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. You've joined us on so many adventures, from disc golf to camping deep up into the woods. You're a true trooper in my book. Yeah. Jeremiah.
Turn.
Oh, man. All right. Jeremiah, so many memories you and the boys of I have shared along the years. I'm grateful to be able to know you and them. I lost where I was.
Sorry.
You're alright. Yeah, anyways. And I look forward and couldn't be happier for you, Amanda, and to see your guys' future. I want to read a quick poem from Maya Angelou. We, unaccustomed to courage, exiled from delight, live coiled and shelled of loneliness until love leaves its high holy temple and comes into our sight to liberate us into life. Love lives, and in its train comes ecstasy, old memories of pleasure, ancient histories of pain. Yet we are bold. Love strikes away the chains of fear from our souls. We are winged and timid in the flush of love's light. We dare be brave, and suddenly we see that love costs all we are and will ever be. Yet it is only love which sets us free. If all of you could please join us in a toast to the amazing Mr. and Mrs. May.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm, first of all, I'm not going to look at either of them or I'll cry hard, so sorry. My name is Lindsay, and I'm the younger and very proud sister of Amanda. And I was so excited for this moment because it's like finally my time to tell all the embarrassing stories about Amanda. But the reality is, there's not really a lot. Like, there's your run-of-the-mill, like, walk past your crush's house, and like, I know all these weird things. However, all of them make me look super weird. So I'm going to just like pass by all of those. Yeah, I am. But in thinking of all those memories I had about her, I just thought about like how supportive she's always been and how consistent she's always been. And no matter what I've ever chosen to do, Amanda's always just wanted to know how she could support me through that. And I think that speaks really highly to the character of who she is and what she's about and what she represents. And I think that also puts out to the universe what she's trying to attract in a partner as well. And I see that in Jeremiah as well. Like, even his constant support for me and for Amanda and for our family has just been really incredible to see. And I remember the first time that Amanda told me about Jeremiah. We were laying in bed eating Chinese food, and we had spent weeks watching, I don't know if you've seen it, but Twin Peaks. And we had been just like waiting to see finally what happened to Laura Palmer. And Amanda is getting these messages on her phone, and I'm like, who is this Jeremy guy? Like, I just have to know what happens. Why is he distracting you from this? And he's kind of telling me, and I'm like, okay, yeah, whatever. And then a couple of weeks had passed, and I had met Jeremiah for the first time. I was like, oh, I get it. Like, I get why he was worth interrupting our Chinese in our pitching a television show for. Like, he has something special to him. And then meeting him, spending time with him, and then the first time that I knew that he was the one that Amanda was meant to be with is, it was the first sporting game we had, sorry, look that way, I can't. It was the first sporting game we had gone to together, and he got his way to our coveted first row spots. I'm like, oh, he's meant to be here. We have the same loathing for the same player, and there's nothing that bonds two people better than that, than loathing the same person. And so, like, in that moment, I just knew that they were meant to be, and then goes the nerves, too. Like, our whole family is really close, and so of meeting his family, and of like, oh, are we going to fit in? Are we going to mesh well together? And then meeting any of the Mays, they've been nothing but kind and genuine, and to see that he shares the same bond with his family that we share, that Amanda and I always share together, I just knew that this is finally what she had been looking for and what he had been looking for as well. And it's been really beautiful to see the way that they've just integrated themselves into each other's lives and the way that they've extended kindness to our family. And just, there's nothing more than a younger sister that you want than for your sister to just find ultimate happiness and for someone who like makes her feel seen and loved. And it's just been really incredible to see that for that to be in Jeremiah. And so just like, it's hard to think that today, like, there's a lot of preparation that goes into a wedding and planning, and that this isn't the end, this is the beginning, and to see where they're going to go together and how our families are just going to grow together. It's just really, really, really exciting for me to see, and just like, thank God that they found each other and that their past have brought each other to each other. And that, I mean, just as Blake was saying when he was officiating today, that just those small steps of obedience brought them together, like going to church together, finding each other, Jeremiah pursuing Amanda. And I'm just so glad that it all ended up this way and that we're here today. And just, I mean, raise a glass, and for as the days go in the future, cheers to the Mays.
Thank you.